Welcome back. TTAG has expressed concern about unlawful activities of Russians. TTAG Chairman Ralph D'Souza has said that if such activities continue, then it will affect Goa's tourism. He has warned government that some criminals are operating in the guise of hawkers and beggars, and government should curb their activities.
Travel and Tourism Association of Goa held a press conference on Friday in Panaji. Ralph D'Souza was asked by media whether Russian mafia in Goa is affecting the tourism in the state. He said, if their illegal activities increase, then it will affect the tourism.
It has not affected yet, but if it escalates, if there are some big instances, there's definitely that side it will. Like there's a drug fight or drug war or something of that sort.
Ralph said that some criminals are operating in the guise of beggars and hawkers. He alleged that the begging activities are taking place under the nose of Goa police.
All this thrives in the confusion, and all these criminals hide in the confusion of the hawkers. Even the thieves find these hawkers as a cover. Anything that is left on the beach today is robbed. Nothing is left there. So if we get rid of the beggars and hawkers from the beaches, half the problems will be over and the beach management will be somewhat a reality in Goa. Well, if the beggars and hawkers are allowed to be there, when the police are there, definitely they are doing it under the nose of the police.
TTAG has supported the government's plan of implementing tourist security organization. Hoteliers and tourist operators have decided to donate 20 jeeps and 15 motorbikes for the cause.
Major hoteliers and tour operators are donating jeeps and vehicles to this security force for them to be mobile, for them to be more proactive, and for them to be more effective. There are 20 Bolero jeeps that we are targeting, and 15 Splendor motorbikes. This force will be manning the beach areas, and if needed, even some of the areas which are very frequently visited by tourists.
A reporter in Panaji, Laukik Shilkar, with video journalist Ravindra Dalvi.
Administration Kaminidad of South Goa demolished three illegal structures at Tolsajor, Madgaon. Investigation is also on against the illegal structures on the Kaminidad land.
The demolition was carried under the leadership of Administrator of South Goa Zone Prashant Shirodkar. Three structures were demolished on Friday. Madhu Pant, whose hut was demolished, claims that he has been staying here from 1.5 years.
Red Varsal he banned door open. Ani voting card sagun anga sagun kella anga sagun. Ani
en chandum kitle is pole sanglele. Motta hona.
मोड़ता मनने काले ऑर्डर आला सर मोड़ता मनने सगळे घर मोड़ता मनने काल मन सांगला सर
तुमका खबर आ बेकायदेशीर
म्हणून हाय खबर ते सांगले ते
अटॉर्नी सेलेस्टिनो नरोना इन्फॉर्मड अस दैट इन्क्वायरी अगेंस्ट अदर इलीगल स्ट्रक्चर्स इन दिस एरिया इज ऑन
वी आर आइडेंटिफाई अबाउट थ्री
स्ट्रक्चर्स
या वी हैव जस्ट लुकन आउट टू नाउ
ओके एंड थर्ड वन
वी आर गोइंग टू दिस गोइंग अप एंड डूइंग
सो ऑल आर
ऑन कुंदा मार्गम कुंदा लाइन
And what about other structures?
Yeah, we are in the process of making the survey of that.
Okay.
And we'll be going forward with the demolition at a later stage.
Our reporter from Margaon, Samir Bhatt.
Mapsa police arrested ex-president of Sirsai Kaminidad Pandurang Parab and ex-treasurer Nashiket Parab on Thursday. They are allegedly involved in a multi-crore scam involving sale of Kaminidad plots. Police have charged the duo with forgery, criminal trespass and the criminal breach of trust. They have been remanded to 5 days police custody.
Both the accused had applied for anticipatory bail. The bail was rejected by the Mapsa Additional Sessions and District Court. Mapsa police arrested them on Thursday. They are charged for selling around 283 plots valued at rupees 4 crores. It's alleged that the duo illegally sold the plots and misappropriated Kaminidad's revenue. President of Sirsai Kaminidad, Ratnakar Parab, mentioned about the charges on the accused office bearers.
Yanjani, amcha komrada je jamini che pas पाचशे सुमार प्लॉट इंडिव्हिज्युअल असे दिलं आहे, विकलं आहे त्यांच्यानी. आणि ते प्लॉट प्लॉटाचे पैसे आमच्या कोंबड्या देऊन त्यांच्याने हे करू ना, जमा करू ना, त्याका लागून त्यांचे आम्ही केस घातले.
Ratnakar Parab informed that in spite of complaining to the administrator of Bardes, administrator failed to take necessary action.
Administrator ko ami complaint dili, tyachya administration ka actionch gheu na, mhanun ami magir court a gele. Administration tyachya janna ami kele ugadki gele, tyanna administration tyachya kithe tari action gheu jay asli, tyane kay gheu na action.
DYSP of Mapsa Semi Tavares is investigating the case. Tavares informed that the report in the above case has been submitted to the High Court.
They illegally allotted the Tunda plots of various allottees without the approval of the government, and subsequently they have also opened an account in the bank at Sirsai without the approval, and they operated it. The Ratnakar Parab has filed a writ petition before the Honorable Court, and Honorable High Court is monitoring the investigation. So a report has been submitted to the Honorable High Court.
Agnel D'Souza, an ex-committee member of Sirsai Comunidad, was arrested earlier by Mapsa police and remanded to 7 days police custody. A reporter from Mapsa, Shyam Sundar Fatte, for Prudent Media.
The next time you think of a male-dominated sport and you think of tug-of-war, then think again. The V.M. Salgaonkar College of Law organized their two-day annual event called Tatwa. Tatwa saw massive participation of students and around 8 colleges. Tatwa is being held at the Taligaon Community Hall in Taligaon.
The events on the card for day 1 included a very unique tug-of-war only for girls. A treasure hunt would span the length and breadth of Panji and surrounding areas. A delicious mocktail making competition and a mute beat. But by far the most challenging event was the treasure hunt. We caught a team on the way.
7 clues till now.
And how many more to go for you all?
I have no clue.
Okay, and you all are searching now for a clue. You are searching for the 8th clue. Okay, and let's see if this team is going to get it.
Any idea?
Fill in the blank kind of a thing. Yeah, I do know, but I can't tell you.
Can you please
Not really, I can't tell you anyway.
But
the mocktail making competition too was hardly fought battle, although it ended in a sweet delight. Here are some of the highlights of the event. From Taligaon, our features reporter Nikhil Pereira with video journalist Anil Sanadi for Prudent Media.
Stay tuned to Prudent for more news after a short break.